Intergalactic planet jumping, planet jumping, intergalactic, intergalactic planet jumping. Welcome back, sports fans. I'm Ryan Van Hook.
And I'm Jeff Lindsay. The Rebs football team continued their hot start this season with a 42-21 win over Pomona Pitzer. Quarterback Blake Box once again had a solid game, throwing for 215 yards and three scores. On the ground, Kevin Vieira led the Lynx rushing attack with 169 yards and a touchdown, while Rock Sherrill picked up two scores of his own. Defensively, Trey Hooper led the Lynx with 11 tackles, while Joseph Raby added 8 tackles and a sack. Rebs will kick off conference play next weekend in Rome, Georgia against Berry College at 1 o'clock Eastern Time. You can find the feed online at RebsLynx.com. And now from the gridiron to the pitch, how do the Rebs football teams do this weekend?
The women's soccer team had three games this week and started with a win over Carthage College on Wednesday, 2-1. The goals were scored by the Lynx in the 78th and the 80th minutes. Hannah Sellner netted the first goal off a Sarah Rostamo pass, and then Nicolette Glidden scored the game winner off a Hannah Sellner pass. The Lynx then fell in consecutive tough one-goal losses to UT Dallas and Hardin-Simmons University. Both lone goals were scored after the 70th minute. After this week, the Lady Lynx are 4-3-1 on the season, and their next game is September 28th at 12 p.m. against Elmhurst College at home. The men's soccer team was also in action this week and lost a nail-biter to Christian Brothers University on Thursday, 1-0. Riley Sheen was able to grab 7 saves in all 90 minutes of the contest. The men then looked to bounce back on Saturday but fell to Belhaven University 3-1. The lone goal for the Lynx was scored by Mark Robinson off an Alec Rhodes pass. Riley Sheen again played all 90 minutes in goal and grabbed another 7 saves. After this week, the men are 2-4-1 on the year, and they will be in action again on September 26th as they travel to take on Principia College. Jeff, was the Rhodes field hockey team able to keep their hot streak alive this weekend?
Well, they sure did. The Rhodes field hockey team started off conference play with a 2-0 win over Hendricks College this Saturday, improving to 5-1 on the season. Defender Shawnee Cohen put in a Mary Rose Hazel pass early in the second half in the back of the net to start the scoring for the Lynx. Kennedy Brislin also had a goal for the Lynx, while freshman Laura Eckelkamp contributed 3 saves in the shutout and goal. Rhodes will retake the field next weekend at Swanee. The Rhodes volleyball team suffered another tough set of losses, falling to Swanee and Center 3-0 this weekend. Alicia Williams had 12 kills for Rhodes, while senior Molly Newborn added 6 kills of her own. Rhodes will hit the road again next weekend with back-to-back conference games at Millsaps and Birmingham Southern. And another Rhodes sports team kicked off their season this weekend. How did the Rhodes tennis team do in their first tournament?
The women's tennis team opened their fall season in the ITA Regionals on Saturday. Amelia McIsaac won big, 8-3, and advanced to the semifinals in the A-Draw consolation bracket. She and Morgan Wilkins also won big, 8-0, in the A-Draw doubles bracket. To see full results from the tennis weekend, please go to RhodesLynx.com.
And that's it for another edition of the Rhodes College Athletic Weekly Update. I'm Jeff Livesey.
And I'm Ryan Van Hook. Adios, Lynx Gatos, and see you next week.